Okay, let's go again. Chef goes in to move the roll in, like you see right here. All right. And then he can move it. The entire roll can go. We'll move either all the way left or all the way right to adjust, okay? These all function fine. Now, once we get the roll in, we'll thread it. Similar to over here. Depending on how you want it. This is the cutter slitting station. And we've gotten multiple cuts out of this thing, right? At one time, how many of most cuts you ever got at once, probably?
10
cuts at once. We could take one master roll and cut it in 10 smaller rolls. However width you set these up. It's known as bales. They have to be sharpened, and of course, the blades. Pretty simple design. They just attach here. Then this bar, when you're ready to go, kicks it in, right, State? Kicks those down. They all set. Drop down. Then he does that, slides over, and gets it tied against the bale part. All right, they all sit down in the middle, and then he slides them over to the bale, to the snug. And he won't turn right now just yet, because he's got that on it, but he could. Then we come over here, and this thing can run, what, a 50-inch diameter?
Yes, 50.
Okay, 50-inch. These are is an iron shaft. He'll shaft that thing up, put a roll in it. It'll sit down. He'll attach air to it. When he does, this little balloon or whatever will expand and hold that core in place. And he's gonna go ahead and raise it up. Right there it is. And he'll hook air right there. And you see those come up. And take air off of it there, you'll see. Does that, they suck back down into the recesses, and then you can pull the shaft out. And this thing, let's see if we can get a little bit of wind in here. This thing will absolutely fly if we let it, boys. I don't know how many feet a minute it will go, but so far about every time faster than we want it to, right? I mean, faster than we have a requirement for, I'll put it like that. But now, might sound a little odd because we don't have any paper on it, but he loads that down, that holds it, threads the roll up right there, your blank empty core, and he'll start turning it. It has a real slow turn speed till you get your cut set right, okay? And it's a real simple design too. He just uses these controllers here, that reestablish button there, and then I guess turn it a little bit faster if you want. He can, okay, there you go. Turn it pretty sensitive. We make that baby really, really hum if we want, okay? And that's pretty much that machine, all right? Everything's functional on that. This does not have a roll, it does have a roll kicker, doesn't have a roll kicker. Doesn't have a roll kicker, but we normally put a fork truck right here and we push it off, don't we? You just push it off onto the fork truck and then we take the roll down like that. Now your slitter blades and everything on this is we normally have our own design to blow it out. You see little pieces like this, but we'll take a tail end if we're trimming a roll up, put the slitter thing down there and blow it into a Gaylord box, don't we?
Mm-hmm. All right. Yes.
And then that Gaylord box we'll take down and bale. All right, and that is the Cameron. Got one machine left. That's the 110-inch cutter over there. And we